We are given the graph of f of x below, and we're asked to graph f inverse of x. If f of x is a one-to-one function whose ordered pairs are x, y, then the inverse function, f inverse of x, is a set of ordered pairs y, x. Which means if we find several points on the graph of f of x, and then interchange the x and y values, the new ordered pairs will give us points on the graph of f inverse of x. It's also important to recognize the given function is one-to-one because only one-to-one functions have inverse functions. Recall, the graphical test to determine if a function is one-to-one is to use the horizontal line test, where if a horizontal line never intersects a graph in more than one point, then the graph does represent a one-to-one function. It may appear as if at y equals 2 there's more than one point of intersection there, but there's actually not. And we should know this because this looks like a cubic function. And now let's determine points on the graph of f of x that hopefully have integer coordinates. So let's use the x-intercept, the y-intercept, this point. Now let's select two more points. Let's say this point here, and let's say this point here. These last two points may not be integer coordinates, but we'll do the best we can. Working our way from left to right, the ordered pair for this point is negative 3, negative 5. And then we have negative 2, 0. We have 0, 2, 2, 4, and let's say 3, 9. So now if we interchange the x and y values for these five points, the new ordered pairs will give us points on the graph of f inverse of x. So we're interchanging the x and y values of negative 3, negative 5. We have negative 5, negative 3, which is here. Next, interchanging the x and y values of negative 2, 0, we have 0, negative 2. Next, we'd have 2, 0, followed by 4, 2. Again, I'm simply interchanging the x and y values for the points that we found on f of x. And finally, we have 9, 3. The graph of f inverse of x must pass through these five red points. Another property that's helpful to recognize is that if we graph f of x and f inverse of x on the same coordinate plane, their reflections across the line y equals x. So let's also graph the line y equals x. And now let's do our best to graph f inverse of x. And again, recognizing the graphs of f of x and f inverse of x are reflections across y equals x. The graph of f inverse of x is this red graph. And notice how it does appear as if the blue and red graphs are reflections across the line y equals x. Of course, if we needed to, we could find additional points on the graph of f of x, interchange x and y values to find more points on the graph of f inverse of x. I hope you found this helpful.